Hello everyone and welcome to this third video about blended learning. In this video I will tell a little bit about other digital tools that I have found useful in my own teaching. My name is Jens Myhre Pedersen and I'm associate professor at Aalborg University. So one of the tools that I really like to use to facilitate group discussions and collect inputs is the one called Padlet. Because I always found that when you have group work and every group has to present their own work, it often becomes that you have 30 minutes of group work and 30 minutes of presentation, which is not so interesting, and where most people are more interested in preparing their own presentation than in actually listening in what is coming up. So here is just a demonstration of one way to use Padlet. And in this case, we had four different questions the groups were working on, and throughout the session, they could enter here the different answers to the different questions they had. So in this way, you can actually ask a number of questions, you can discuss it in groups, and throughout the session, you bring it all onto a joint board so everyone can see what the other groups are bringing in. And afterwards, you also have a very good documentation and you can use it afterwards without having to write your notes or take pictures and so on. So that's one tool I like to use. Another tool I really like is the one called Kahoot, which is a quiz tool for making in-class gamification. So basically the idea is that if you have a classical presentation with slides, you can build in some questions and then the students will have to answer, and they have to answer as fast as possible and find the right question, find the right answer. And in this way you build up a gamification and you can have a scoreboard running throughout the class. But you can also use it in much more creative ways, for example by having smaller groups and then having the groups to come up with questions, with answers for the questions that you are raising during the class. So these two I think are really good for kind of in-class discussions. Then there is a tool which is called Discord, which is a collaboration platform. It used to be a gaming platform, but it actually works quite well also for collaboration, and we had several groups working across distances and using this as the main communication platform. It is not so good for sharing of documents, so the students need to have other tools for that. But in order to have a chat going on, in order to do video conferences, audio conferences, and keeping track of it, it's quite good. And you can have different rooms, so you can have different rooms for different activities. So for example, you can have one room where you have the supervisor involved, and you can have one room where you have just the students, and you can even have a social room, and you can have a room across projects and so on. So that works quite nicely for that. And then, even though I hate to say it, I still think that Facebook is really good for community building, because Facebook is something that everyone has, so it has a very high accessibility, a very high availability. Many people have it in their phones, on their computers, on their other devices. So if you want to stay in touch and share some common theme, then Facebook is actually quite nice. Where do we use it? One place we're using it is what we call AAU and Friends Hackers, which is a community for students and others who are interested in cybersecurity. Another place we have been using it is in different Erasmus Plus projects, where we have students from different institutions. So the students are used to all kind of different tools, all kind of different learning management systems, and it's very hard to find one common place that everyone is in. And our experience has been that if we do it and have a specific tool or a specific platform that we use just for the project, because it's such a small part of the students' time they actually spend there, they forget to see updates, they forget to see messages. But if you're using Facebook, because people are using it anyway, then it's very good. The downside is, of course, all the data discussion, and the downside is also that very often you will find other teachers or students who, by principle, will not be using Facebook, and I think that will not be less in the future. So, thanks for listening.